start. Dear candidates, sadly, due to COVID-19, I have to focus now on the camera. And I have to welcome your family and friends via the camera and via the live stream. It's up there, so welcome to you as well. On behalf of Maastricht University, and particular on behalf of the Faculty of Health, Medicine and Life Sciences, I want to welcome you to this special meeting. And this meeting is special because it is a meeting of the Board of Examiners, and it is the only goal to graduate students and to present certificates. My name is Nienke de Jong, and I'm the chair of the Board of Examiners. And today, 10 students will graduate from the Master Global Health. Let's open this session officially. So, open. Yeah. First of all, we will start with a speech of the dean, of our faculty, and she wants to welcome you as well. So I would like to start a video.
Dear students in the room, and some of you, just like me and your family and friends online, welcome at this memorable moment for all of you, the graduation ceremony at Maastricht University. My name is Annemie Scholz, proud dean of the Faculty of Health, Medicine and Life Sciences. And students, you should also be extremely proud of yourself and shine. Despite the fact that there is no graduation ceremony in our beautiful St. John's Church in the center of Maastricht, your beloved ones cannot join you, and no reception and large parties afterwards. But be proud, because yes, you are certainly a special class and deserve deep respect for your resilience and perseverance. 2020 has been a bizarre year. Science, education and student life has altered impressively. You needed to adapt to a continuously changing perspective in your social, cultural and professional interactions. In the spring, those of you who were following an educational program had to adapt in a split second from on-campus to online education, in your student accommodation or back home. Many of you were doing a research or clinical internship where you want to prepare optimally for the next step in your student or professional career. Often an extremely valuable hands-on experience in a lab or the clinic, in Maastricht, elsewhere in the Netherlands or abroad. And this demanded a lot of creativity and flexibility from yourself, our staff and network. And then in the summer, after finishing a study, and entering a next phase, normally many of you would prepare for a shorter or longer holiday or experience abroad. These plans needed to be adapted too. But here you are, you made it. Congratulations to you and also to your proud parents and friends and family. I sincerely hope that you can find an additional special way of celebrating this together. And then the next step. Well, what the corona crisis is showing us very clearly is that you are needed. Professionals in all domains focusing on health from the different angles that we offer at our faculty. Good luck, and let's keep in contact also as FHML alumni. I would also like to take the opportunity to thank the FHML staff over the past months to make this happen. Thank you very much and enjoy the ceremony.
Okay, I would like to thank the dean, our dean of the faculty, Professor Scholz. Now I would like to introduce the persons behind the table. from the right side, here is the current program director, Dr. Klabbers, and next to her on her right side is the former program director, Dr. Meershoek. And I would like to invite you, Dr. Meershoek, to welcome you as well. Okay, the floor is yours.
Good afternoon and welcome, family, friends, supervisors, others, but above all, you candidates. I'm happy to see you here and to know that others will attend the next session today or are joining online. This is a very special moment, and I'm very proud that so many students are graduating today, in time, in this extraordinary year in which you were confronted with quite some additional challenges. It's only 13 and a half months ago that we first met in this lecture hall. Maybe you remember at the introduction day. Well, it was very crowded then. You cannot imagine that anymore. And maybe it is also a bit difficult to recall how the world looked like and when you arrived here in Maastricht. But let me help you. Sitting all together, you were enthusiast and excited to start a new endeavor in your life. Curious, and at least some of you a bit insecure about what would come. But what actually happened this year was far beyond what you could have imagined at that time. For us as faculty, the first months of the program were business as usual. Around this time of the year, half of October, as usual, some of you felt overwhelmed by all the readings introducing you in theories, concepts, and debates in the field of global health, by the methodology course that started with qualitative research, which for most of you required a so-called gestalt switch, a paradigm switch in your thinking by questioning principles and certainties you took for granted for a long time. And then you were thrown in serious statistics. Valeria Lima-Pasos always tells us in the team that you hate her. But I'm sure that's not true. Maybe she did not convince all of you how lovely statistics can be, but I'm sure you agree that you were lucky to have her and her dedicated team as your teachers. While trying to digest this all, you also had to take all kinds of decisions about electives and thesis research topics, arrange visas, and, well, all these kind of things. But you all survived the first term. Some of you were quite exhausted at that time and decided to escape the Maastricht regime to explore global health at one of our partner universities. And while starting to get used to the new environment and educational approaches, it slowly became clear that the term might not finish as expected. It took a while before the real magnitude and consequences of the crisis became apparent. But finally, there was no escape. You had to travel back home, and education went completely online. And what had been a very frustrating experience at several times during the first term proved its relevance now. With your well-developed competences in online working, this was a rather smooth switch for all of you. But then a very tough time started, and we all regret it was impossible to go to Manipal. Although we tried our best to organize an online alternative, sitting behind your computer at sometimes very huge distance from your classmates can never replace a real-life collaboration. Some of you felt lonely and struggled to keep going. Others had to deal with loss and grievance in family circle. And all of you had to change thesis topics. And instead of traveling to other countries to explore new environments and meet new people, most of you had to do desk studies or online interviews. Not less relevant, but completely different from what you were looking forward to. The fact that you are sitting here today in the room or maybe at home, and that most of your classmates will follow soon, show your resilience. You all showed great flexibility in adjusting to the new circumstances and creativity in designing new projects with the small margins of what was possible. It was a tough year, especially this year with the additional challenges Corona brought. You helped and supported each other with the workload and all decisions that had to be taken in the first term and in what we consider now as the old normal time. You created the basis for a strong bond among each other, a sense of belonging. And I hope and think that that bond helped you to face the challenges in the second and third term. And I'm convinced that will also a highly relevant network for your future. Now you're sitting here, young, ambitious, and well-skilled young professionals. We are very proud of you, and we have all confidence that you will find your place within the field of global health and will make a difference in the future. Although this is a very insecure time and far from easy to start a career, you have one great, well, advantage. If one thing is obvious for everyone worldwide, then it is the relevance of global health as a discipline, and this will hopefully help you in the future. We would appreciate if you stay in touch and let us know how your career is going. Maybe then in the near future you can function as a thesis placement supervisor or guest lecturer, supporting new students in their introduction in the field of global health. But for now, take the time to be proud of what you have accomplished, and I hope you will find a way to celebrate this with friends and family now and or in the near future. Congratulations also for the family, friends, and others. Well, the students that are here present have to wait a little bit longer. Before we go on with handing over the certificates, I would like to give some attention to all the ones that were not able to be present in person in this ceremony. And although we are proud on all the ones that graduated between September last year and now, I will limit the list of students from the batch 2019-2020 to, well, give them some attention because they also struggled this year. Well, also graduating today is Jeffrey Arhin, Johanna Babilas, Lotte Bijkerk, Sarah Boyle, Dana Brandenburger, Alex Brown, Heidi Chen, Dina Chen, Joep Klaassen, Lucy Coates, Rosin Conan, and this is special attention, she graduated with distinction, Anouk Kremers, Michael Cummings, Chiagozi Dan Nwankwo, Joshua Data, Anna Sofia Domit Cordova, Orla Donnelly, Grace Downey, Iba Mohamed El Kalamawi, Esther Escriva Tarda, Alice Fleming, Nadia French, Rosemary James, Molly Kearney, Viagra Kenen, Sigrid Kramer, Quentin Tortorek, Ewan Lowry, and then again, this graduated with distinction, Alice Louis, Michael McGovern, Celia Mir Alvarez, James Mitchell, Megan Norris, Patricia Ogba, Vanessa Ruan, Mara Scherner, Rhea Schoustra, Ephraim Sedetta, Anna Stapleton, Mia Amelie Sherman, Johanna Taylor, Corina Telman, Neve Toll, Fabian van den Broek, Valeska van Wiekede, Morgan Weiland, Rianne Wells, Emily Whiteside en Elena Sadanel. congratulations with your graduation. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Dr. Meershoek. We will continue now to the actual graduation, and I want to explain the procedure. So let's start, because, let's start. So I will mention the name of the candidate. So, or you come downstairs here, or that way, here. Then here are the certificates. You grab them yourself. And over there, up there, is the camera. So I would like you to address, to involve the onliners to stay here for a few seconds. Yeah, and I will congratulate you here from there. Then you continue to here to a present. You take it yourself, the present. And then at the end, Dr. Meershoek is giving you a rose. With the rose and the certificate, you're standing in front of this... and then a picture will be taken. Okay, so that's the procedure. Now let's start. We will start. Yeah, and we will start with a student who finished her study with distinction, cum laude. And it means this student performed very well during the entire program. Yeah, and that's Michelle Kusters. So, even kijken. It's over there. Yeah, congratulations. Camera is up there. Yeah. Okay, we will continue with the next candidates, and in between we have a kind of intermezzo. We will ask one of the candidates to speak over here and speak on behalf of students. Yeah, okay, but let's continue with Marleen Blom. Congratulations! It's important to just stay here and congratulations. Yeah. Then we go to Miriam Shedadi. Yeah, congratulations. We continue with Leila Hiravi. Congratulations. Go to Alexandra Humpert. Congratulations. Now, at this point, I would like to invite Gabriella Warning to say something on behalf of the candidates. Yeah?
Dear professors, associate professors, and fellow students, both here and online, good afternoon. Everybody, take a deep breath. Inhale, exhale. We did it. We made it. Not only all of us here, but everybody who's also present here online, we made it. If only we could go back in time to our stressed out selves, back when Google Drive was our Bible, while we were hopping from deadline to deadline, a time where we studied everything from the foundations of global health to governing health in a global context. A time during which some of us also discovered our personal foundations and of what we are capable of, and we discovered that we are able to govern so many assignments all at once. And oh, how can I forget statistics? Need I say more? But huge shout out to Valeria, because she did a great job for guiding us through it all. And we acknowledge her extra time and effort she put into making us understand it, because apparently we did. Then during the elective, each of us had a different experience. While our global health cohort was once in this very lecture hall, we dispersed all over the globe. We gained new insights in Colombia, Canada, Maastricht, Norway, India, Thailand. However, we eventually had all one thing in common: COVID-19. Which brings me to my next point. What a time to be studying global health. In a way, we had impeccable timing, and therefore we were the perfect cohort. The fall term was the good old days. We experienced working together in groups. We worked together in real life. We sat together next to each other in lecture halls during flu season. We would cough like we were the coughing choir without second thought. It was all good. And then during winter term, we could see firsthand, with fresh knowledge, how the pandemic unfolded, how different countries responded, which factors came into play, and the consequences of these. To me, the most remarkable thing was observing human behavior during this pandemic. Then came the summer term. In the midst of the chaos of the pandemic, while tackling our thesis, many of us had to become very creative, but we did adapt, and we had to overcome, and we did. In short, we had a very rigorous year. If only we could go back to all of that, to tell ourselves that it will all turn out well, as long as we keep working hard and we keep working smart. We could show ourselves a glimpse of what today will be like. Granted, it might not be exactly what we imagined it. My parents, for instance, they took the risk and they flew 9 hours to be here, all to not be invited. But it is all for the greater good. We, of all people, should understand that. Even though today might be a little different, let's not underestimate the value of today. I've noticed that lately the focus is put too much on what's next, but we should also focus on what we have achieved, how far we have come. So let today be drenched in feelings of happiness, joy, fulfillment. But most importantly, let today be all about you, because no matter what anybody says, no matter how hard it was, you did it. Well, I did it too. During this master, you learn to cope with pressure, deadlines, multitasking, thinking out of the box, having lived before and during a pandemic. So I also want to give a special thanks to all the professors, the associate professors, all the tutors that were affiliated with this program. A special thank you to Agnes and Honi for answering all our hundreds of emails, hearing our complaints, for being there for us. We've experienced living before and during a pandemic. One thing is for sure though, what the after part of COVID-19 looks like is not set in stone. Even though it has already brought so many hardships, it eases my mind knowing that each of you can mean something different and change the after picture of COVID-19. From a bleak future filled with anxiety to innovative and bright. But first, let us celebrate today. And then we change the world. Thank you, everybody.
Thank you, Gabriella. Let's continue. And we take the next pile. Okay. Yeah. Nick de Kuyper. Congratulations. Fatana Mohammed. Congratulations to you. Sophie Scheidel. Yeah. Congratulations. Mick van der Heijden. Congratulations. And now, Gabriele Warning. Yeah. Congratulations. You can sit, because that was the final candidate. Ladies and gentlemen, we have come to the end of this session in which 10 candidates received their master diploma. And I would like to point out some important points. First of all, you have a final assignment. Just check your folder. Are names okay, dates, and so on? So it's not obligatory to do it now, right now. You can do it later. If there is a failure, please send the Board of Examiners an email. Yeah? Then the second point is there is no gathering, so no drink. So and be aware. Please leave the building. As soon as possible, but leave the building. Yeah. Okay. Then after this session, there will be a picture made in this room, and then we will ask row by row to leave the lecture hall. And in about 3 weeks, you will receive an email from the alumni office to your Maastricht account, and you will receive a link to the pictures. Yeah? Okay, that's it. It was a great pleasure for me to be the first to congratulate you. And of course, from this place, I would like to also for the onliners to congratulate you, family and friends. And thank you for watching this graduation. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the end of the meeting. And I would like to close the meeting officially. Also closed. Okay, thank you. And this is the end, and I would like to ask you to follow the orders from the photographer, how to stand and for the picture. Yeah?
Okay.